blessed. But vacay, I feel better at work. I mean, whatever it's worth, I give whatever I'm worth for my nigga. Who gon' go to hell and back for me? I'ma give him heaven on earth for a hell of a check, yeah, whichever come first. Blessings on blessings on blessings. Look at my life, man, that's lessons on lessons on lessons. I treat the beat like it's a reverend. I tell the truth like, Father, forgive me. These are all my confessions, man. This wasn't luck, it was destined. I done lost homies who been with me since Ed, Ed, and Eddie, who flip like confetti. And then when you back, they back to call you dog. That shit can get petty. Don't get no dap to me. Funny thing about talking behind my back is that it just keep coming back to me. Was off for a sec, now it's back to me. You mad at me, this ain't what I want, man, it's what it had to be. This is that late night working after three, man. This is why my old girl was mad at me. This why I'm your majesty, man. The click is the tightest, the
push the tightest,
the drinks are the coldest, the future the brightest, the feet not divided, the love is divided, and I just gotta thank God that we got it. Bless. I don't know what I would do without a crew. Look like we robbed a bank, but all we make is deposits. Your profit will profit, oh God. I'm here for a good time, not a long time, you know. I haven't had a good time in a long time, you know.
Waiting to get loaded inside.
Way up, I feel blessed. Way up, I feel blessed.
Straight up.
I'm way up, I feel blessed.
Straight up.
Well, I feel blessed. I ain't gonna say that we're back for nothing, cause that implies that we're back from something. If we're back from something, it's some checks you owe.
I decided to do a quick video. Little app I've been using. Kind of helps me out a lot. Again, one of my favorite apps is Trucker Path. I use it a lot. Especially when I'm about ready to shut down at the end of the night. But most guys, when you pick up your load, one of the first things you're going to try to figure out is, okay, I need to weigh my load. Where's the closest cat skin? Now, through my trucking career, I've been through a couple of trainers who used to tell me all the time, I don't weigh my loads anymore. I pretty much know what my load is, where to put it at. Well, that's always taking a chance. And usually, when you weigh your load, you don't pay for it. The company pays for it. So my question to those experienced drivers is, why do you take the chance when you're not even paying for it? I weigh all my loads. I'm not paying for it. The last thing I want to do is get on the DOT inspection and my load's overweight, no matter what tandem it is, or just overweight. It's like, why are you taking that chance, and why do you want to pay that fine when the company will pay for the weight scale, and they're always coming. And if you get the little sheet from CAT scale, that's proof that you weighed your load, and your load is in standard. So I still don't understand the philosophy behind not weighing your loads. It's a simple fact that you too lazy and you just don't want to waste your time. But consequences could be great. But anyway, I weigh all my loads, and I'll show you a little neat little app that I use. Alright, this neat little app here is again, you guys remember my phone has a little cracked screen. I got about 2 more weeks before I can get a new phone. It's called the CAT scale. It's a neat little app you can download, doesn't cost you anything. Again, as you know, my favorite app, Trucker's Path. But with CAT scale, let's say that we just got loaded and we're ready to pull off from here. What I would do is like, okay, where's my the closest CAT scale I can get to? Well, if I push this little CAT scale app, okay, and you go down to find CAT scales. Alright, then you go to search by current location. That's the location that's closest to you. And it gives you a nice little list of CAT scales. Now there's one, Lancaster Travel Plaza, which is about 10.77 miles away. Again, that looks to be the closest, so what I would do is just click on it. And lo and behold, it gives me a little bit more information. What I love about it is it gives me the Latin long. And you could use take me to this location, but I usually use my GPS because it's trucker's GPS. And what I'll do is I'll put that Latin long in and I'll go directly to it. Or what you could do is you could also map it out on the map, but I usually just put the location in my GPS. So I go over to my nice little Ramen Alley. Now I have it set up for a location. Of course, it's only 162 miles away, so it's actually not my receiver. It's actually my shipper, but let's pretend like I'm about ready to go to my receiver. And what I would do is go over here, choose destination, put in a new location. And this nice little feature I use a lot, Latin long. So I would put the Latin long on my CAT scale here. 40. And sorry, longitude. Always put in the -7.6. I don't know if that matters or not, but I always do. Okay, got my Latin long in there. Click go. And what you want to do is add it as a via. So add it to your trip and add to start. And of course I would be loaded. And you'll see at the top, it changes. And actually that's my total miles, but we want. So you'll see, about 14 miles away, I have my first CAT scale in. So I don't have to worry about looking for the closest CAT scale driving by. It's already in my GPS. It's going to take me directly to it. And then after it takes me there and I weigh my load, I continues on. And I will continue on to my final destination. So again, this is a quick way to find the CAT scale, weigh your load, and get started on your delivery. Again, this is Jay, Trucker 717. Peace. I've got freight to move.